Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. You're looking at the SSGI graph from the previous time frame with magnitude 5.5 and larger earthquakes. And as we anticipated, we had actually seismic activity above average. We see that on the 8th already, 5.5 at Solomon Islands, 5.5 on the 9th at the Central East Pacific Rise. And then we had a cluster of stronger earthquakes that peaked magnitude 6.3 at the Bismarck Sea, and it occurred all around the 11th, and that was the time that we're in the middle of the convergence, the quadruple conjunction, near quadruple conjunction, as I explained in the previous update. And increased seismic activity occurred, 5.7 at the Ryukyu Islands. That was late on the 13th. And then we had a second cluster of strong earthquakes around the 15th, 16th, following the critical planetary geometry. And we had two strong earthquakes, 6.3 at the Mariana Islands, and it actually peaked 6.5 at the Queen Charlotte Island region in Canada. So we had definitely this increased seismic activity, but no large earthquake, no high 6 or 7 magnitude earthquakes thus far. So let's have a look at the SSGI graph for the coming time frame. That is not going to look all that much better, to be honest. We have a full moon tomorrow and we have a high lunar peak today. And this is because Earth is moving between Mercury and Saturn, yes. And the Moon is aligning with Mercury and with Saturn almost at the same time. This is shortly before the full Moon. If you look at the solar system, we see this geometry here. Earth between Mercury and Saturn, the Moon on the other side facing actually Saturn. And as a result, today, actually right now, this morning as we speak, we see the Moon in a conjunction with Mercury and Saturn within a few hours, about 3 hours. And then we have a full Moon about 24 hours later, it will be tomorrow morning. And then the Moon will also be in a conjunction with Neptune. It's a few hours later. And then finally, Earth will be exact between Mercury and with Saturn, and that will be just following the lunar conjunction. So tomorrow morning we have a full moon, we have the moon lining up with Neptune and also the planetary conjunction with Mercury, Earth and Saturn. It is not all lining up perfectly, so we have the full moon, but at that point the Earth is not yet between the Sun and Neptune. That will be about 3 days later. I'll come to that in a minute. And we see the Moon first lining up with Mercury and Saturn, and only 24 hours later we see that the Earth will be between Mercury and Saturn. I do suspect that there can be a stronger seismic event as a result, and if you go back to the SSGI graph, that could be around the 18th already, 18th or 19th, we could have a stronger seismic event as a response to that planetary and lunar geometry. But I'm not too sure. Again, it's not all lining up perfectly. Then we see a convergence coming up of critical planetary geometry starting on the 19th with right angle geometry involving Mercury, Venus and Neptune. And that will be followed by a convergence of Venus, Sun, Jupiter in a conjunction and Sun, Earth, Neptune. There you have it on the 21st, Sun, Earth and Neptune. So we have two planetary conjunctions converging there. That is going to be a critical situation. If you look at the solar system, there's a lot going on there on the 20th and the 21st. We see Mercury, Venus, Neptune, right angle geometry. And then Venus, Mercury, Neptune also, that will be late on the 19th and early on the 20th. There's not much time in between. And in between, the Moon will be in an alignment with Venus. And then the Sun is going to play a major role here because the next four geometries will involve the Sun. That is Venus, Sun, Jupiter, that is in a conjunction. Then we have Sun, Mercury, Uranus in the right angle geometry, Sun, Earth, Neptune in a conjunction, and that's all later on the 20th and early on the 21st, and then also Sun, Mercury, Mars in a right angle. So the Sun is playing a major role, and if we look at the SSGI sum graph, I don't show that so often actually, we see the high yellow peak, and that is an indication that the Sun is very much involved here. And that also is going to happen later on the 25th. I will come to that later. Back to the SSG iGraph, we see this is the common graph. We see this convergence, 20th, 21st, and then we have the moon in conjunction with Uranus. So we look at the next lunar geometry that can be critical. That is Earth, Moon, Uranus on the 22nd, and then Earth, Moon, Jupiter on the 23rd. And I suspect that with this convergence of planetary geometry on the 20th and the 21st, that a larger seismic event is most likely to occur following those lunar conjunctions. So watch it after the moon lined up with Uranus and with Jupiter on the 22nd and on the 23rd. There could be the largest seismic response to the critical planetary geometry. And then we have on the 25th also an interesting and possibly critical convergence coming up. That will be Mercury, Earth and Neptune in a conjunction. And Earth, Moon, Mars in a conjunction. So the lunar geometry is converging there with the planetary geometry. And also Mercury, Sun, Saturn. And in a right angle geometry, Sun, Venus, Saturn. So again, the Sun will be involved there on the 25th. But I will do an additional update covering that planetary geometry, because we don't know what's going to happen in the coming days. It's too early to tell what will happen following that planetary and lunar geometry on the 25th. So first we focus on the 17th, 18th, with the planetary, especially the lunar geometry, the full moon. And then most critical, in my opinion, will be the 20th, 21st, that planetary geometry, and then following that lunar geometry on the 22nd and on the 23rd with Uranus and Jupiter. The largest seismic event may occur following actually the lunar conjunction with Jupiter, and that could be around the 24th, maybe on the 25th, close to the next planetary geometry. It could go well into the 7 magnitude range, because the convergence on the 20th, 21st, that looks critical. Okay, we have some fluctuations. The latest fluctuations that we picked up, that was yesterday. And we marked regions, that is the Shumajin Gap, South Alaska, Aleutian Islands. And that is a location for a potential megathrust earthquake. I'm not going to say that it's going to occur in the coming week, but that there is the potential there. And also in the South Pacific, but that's not too critical. And also we have the antipode, and that is marking here Iran. And Iran in particular, I think, should be on watch, because it has been a while since stronger seismic activity occurred there, and is marked here by the atmospheric fluctuations. And then also yesterday, fluctuations marking Java, and to the south, the western part of Australia, south of Australia, and to the north, and that is the Assam region. Again, I emphasize Assam region, because it's been about 74 years since megathrust, or let's say a very large earthquake, 8.6 magnitude, occurred in Assam region. And if you look at history, there have been only about 53 years between the two largest earthquakes. That was in 1897. There was an 8.7 magnitude earthquake in Assam. So that region is definitely due if we look at recent seismic history of the region. And also, if you look at this map, we see that, recently in Australia, there has been some seismic activity, moderate activity, both in the west and in the east. And all the while, it has been relatively quiet to the north, that's the Solomon Islands and the Santa Cruz Islands. And there can be major seismic activity. But the last time that occurred, magnitude 7, that was in 2022. So it looks like the region between the Santa Cruz Islands, Solomon Islands and Papua New Guinea, there could be a major seismic event coming up in the short term. And there are also some regions that I like to emphasize. For example, Romania, that recently had a 5.2 magnitude earthquake. And the last time that a major earthquake occurred there with the potential was in the 1970s. And it could go into the high 7 magnitude range, 7.8 magnitude or thereabouts. But usually that seismic activity occurs pretty deep, about 80 or 100 kilometers deep, but it still can cause damage in the region if that were to happen. And it's been a while, so yes, there is certainly the potential for a very large earthquake beneath the Carpathian Mountains. Keep in mind. And then finally, Los Angeles experienced moderate seismic activity since July, the second half of July. Higher 4 magnitude range, just recently another one, widely felt, and also close to 5 magnitude. And Los Angeles and that region, that seems also due, there seems to be some seismic increase there. And if you look at the real large earthquake, the San Andreas Fault in that area, that can produce a high 7 magnitude, around 7.9 magnitude. And the last time that that happened was in the 19th century. So Southern California also seems due. These are the regions that I would like to pay special attention to. Check out the website and our social media channels for the latest updates, especially the atmospheric fluctuations. Okay, this is the seismic and planetary update. For now, stay safe. Until next time.